Hello students, in this video today we are going to solve the Excel task of March 2017, okay? So for that I am going to go for the task related to Excel. So it is starting from page number 6 of this past paper, okay? So whenever you are going to solve any task, first you have to do what? You have to read the instruction very carefully, okay? Like we are going to start this task, so what we are going to do, first we are going to read these instructions, then we are going to solve these steps, okay? So in this section it is saying you are going to prepare a spreadsheet model to calculate the weekly wages of employees. You must use the most efficient method in your spreadsheet. All the currency value, first thing that he is saying that you have to use the efficient methods. Basically we are going to solve this spreadsheet by using the particular formula which has been designed by the Excel, okay? The second thing is asking all the currency values are in Indian rupee to the two decimal places. So this is a important checkpoint. This one is quite important, so we are going to highlight it yellow. Indian rupees to the two decimal places, okay? The next instruction he is saying that employees are paid to work for 50 weeks in each year and get 2 weeks unpaid holiday, okay? So we got here, you can say that they got 20 weeks, they got 20, you can say the 50 paid weeks, okay? We are going to highlight it as well. Then some employees are paid weekly and some are paid monthly salary, okay? So now what we have to do, we have to do what? Open and examine the file, this one, wages, and the second is data, this one in a spreadsheet package, okay? Then he is saying that insert 2 rows at the top of the wages file, add text formatting so the wages spreadsheet look like this word, then save the spreadsheet with the name of this one including the center number and the candidate number, okay? So it is going to give us 10 marks. So first we are going to open these 2 sheets. For that we will go to the files, this one and this one. We are going to open them using the Excel. Okay, so this is the wages, and the second one is, you can see that the data. So we're going to go for the data. First we are going to format properly. For that I have to select this one, and you can go into any column. You, whenever it is going to appear this sign, you have to double click for the proper formation of all cells, okay? Then what he asked us to insert 2 rows at the top of the wages file, okay? So I'm going to insert 2 rows at the top of. For that I'm going to go to the first row, right click, insert 1 row, then again insert 2nd row. I got 2 rows, okay? Then what he asking me that add text formatting so that the wages spreadsheet look like this. We have to follow this formation, okay? This is the text asked by the examiner. I'm going to copy it and paste this one. First, like before pasting that, you can see that he has merged the row from the column from A to G. So I'm going to merge from column A to G, select them, then this is the option center and merge clicked, okay? You can do it also like this is the center merge option, okay? You can do it from it. or you can go to the home tab and you can select this one option, center and merge. Okay, then I'm going to place this text there. Okay, this one the text. Then I'm going to increase the font, bold it, then increase the font. This one. Okay. Then this one. Okay, I guess it's all right. Okay, this is good. From B to F. Okay, I have to increase this one. It is basically B to F. Okay, now it's good. We are good to go. Then he has done what? He has changed the background of this one to gray. So we are going to make it grayish. Like this is the tool. So this looks good. Okay. This one done. Then again, he has changed the headings background to black and the font size to white. So first I am going to do what? I am going to select them all. Okay, I am going to go for black background and the font will be white, this one. Okay, so make it bold. Okay, now it looks good as per examiner requirement. So you can see that our design is quietly as per examiner requirement. Okay, this one is done. Okay, then save as a spreadsheet with the file name, this one, including your center number and the candidate number. For that, all we have to do, what we are going to go for this save as option. Okay, I want to save it here in my working area. Browse it. Then he sent me wages as a spreadsheet. For first thing you have to do, what you have to change the file tab as a Excel workbook. Okay, so this one is selected, done. I'm going to save this thing there, the file, like this one. Okay, so the file is saved. You can see that it is a Excel workbook. If we go to there, this is the Excel workbook. If I'm going to close this one, okay, I'm going to open again this one. So you can see that this one is saved as per our requirement. Okay, so what next? We got 10 marks this, okay, so he was saying that I have to save it as the, sorry, my bad, I have to change its name. It should be March 17, then underscore PK96464/ my candidate number should be 0099. Okay, so I can change that thing before, but anyhow, that was another scenario. Then what? In the next step, you can see that he's saying that place your name, center number, then candidate number on the left in the footer. Place automated file name, which include the file path, on the right of side of the footer. Okay, so it is going to give me 2 marks. So let's do it like this one. I'm going to go for the view tab, this one. I'm going to go for the page layout, this one, this option select. Now you can see the, this is the header and this one is the footer. Okay, this one. So he's asking me what I have to place on the left side, my name, center number and the candidate number. So my name is this one. Okay, and my center number is PK 964. Then My candidate number is 0099. Okay, so on the left right side I have to place a automated file number, file name including the file path. Okay, so this is the file path. I'm going to leave it. Now you can see that he has given me the file path as well as the file name. Okay, so this is how you are going to display. Anyhow, the file path is quite bigger, so sorry for the inconvenience. This is how you are going to include the file path plus file name. Okay, so in the next ask, what he's asking. Okay, so this one is done. But before that, one thing you have to make sure is asking that in evidence number 7, take a screenshot showing that from cell A to G5 your spreadsheet including the row and the column heading placed within the screenshot. Basically saying that I have to make from A1 to G5 the screenshot. Evidence is quite important, students, because you are going to get the marks on the base of evidence. So you have to take care of that very carefully. So for that, let us go to our work is done here, because he's not asking for like footer, header, more. He's asking for the footer. So this one is done. So I'm going to do what? I will go to review. I'm going to go for the normal view. Okay, this one. So it is done. So rest thing is that he's asking I have to place the screenshot. So I'm going to do for what? I have this snipping tool that I usually use to take the screenshots from A1 to G5. This one, okay. I have taken the screenshot, this one. Whether if you want to include the column's name, so that won't be that difficult. That won't be problem, so we can do that also. This one. Asked by the examiner, I have to take the screenshot like this. This one done. I just have to copy this one. I'm going to go for the evidence. This is the evidence. This is the evidence number 7. This one. I'm going to paste it here. So this is pasted as per examiner requirement on the place of evidence number 7. Okay. So let's save it. Then let's get back to our past paper. We were there. Then he is saying that in the cell D4, enter a function to look up the pay type from the contents of the file. Okay, so this one, in the from this file I have to do what? I have to implement a lookup function to get the pay types. Okay, for that I have to do what? And go there. I have to, like, this is the pay type and this is the this one. All I have to enter the pay type. We are going to enter the pay type according to the job code. Okay, so for that I have to implement lookup function. So this data is given us, you can see that as vertical form, so we are going to use that for VLOOKUP. If the data orientation has been formatted as a horizontal in horizontal rows, so we are going to use horizontal like age lookup for that. So as examiner has given us data according to vertical, so if we are going to implement VLOOKUP formula. For starting a function you are going to write equal sign, then I'm going to write VLOOKUP. Okay, this one. In VLOOKUP first you have to do what? You have to give it a lookup value. That is our lies in E4. So lookup value is E4. Okay, then second thing is asking for the table array. Okay, so what is the table array? We will go to the second file, this one. So this is the table array. Okay, this one I only want to use this one because I want file type, so this one is required. Okay, Then we will go, you can see that after placing the comma, he is asking for the column index. Like we are going to match our pay code with this value, this data is required, so I am going to place second index there. Okay, so next he is asking that whether you want to go for the approximate match or the exact match. So we are going to go for the exact match. You can place false here as well as zero. So there I am going to enter the this one. So he has given me the data according to this one. You can see that this job code, the CR, if we are going to match it in the CR, the CR is the pay type of the CR is W. Okay, so it is according to as per requirement we are going to replicate this formula. Okay, till the last, okay, this one we have replicated it. Now you can see that this one. Okay, so this is how you are going to implement VLOOKUP. Then we will go to, you can see that this formula was quite easy and 5 marks allotted by the examiner. Then he say that in step, asking in step 18 what he is saying, that in cell F4 enter a formula to calculate the weekly wage for this employee using the annual salary. Okay, from the this file. Okay, so then the formula must display the weekly wage if only if the pay type is W. Okay, if the pay type is not W, do not display anything. Okay, so first he is saying that we have to calculate, we have to fetch the data from this one, from this file, and we have to calculate the weekly wage. Okay, so let's see if we go to this file. Okay, so they has given us annual wages. So all we have to do, what we have to calculate the, first we are going to fetch the data according to the job code, then we are going to calculate the annual wage. Okay, annual wage, we are going to calculate the weekly wage from this annual wage. Okay, then what? And then he is saying that he is going to display the wage if that person is taking the weekly wage. In the case of the monthly wage, it is going to display me like nothing, none. So for this purpose, first we have to do what? We have to identify that whether that person is going to, whether that person is taking weekly wage or the monthly wage according to pay type. For this purpose we are going to, then if that person is the pay type of this person is weekly, so he is going to display this data from this file, and else if it's not, so it is going to display none. First let us start this, let us implement this criteria, so it will be easier for us to calculate it. So let's say here, let's say we have to do this on implement. If I say for that, if the pay type equal to W, then he is going to display, okay, don't be so hasty, he is going to display show salary, show salary in the second part you are going to display nothing. Okay, so let's say, okay, so it's not showing me anything. The reason is that I have to place inverted points, inverted comma before the W. Okay, next, so let me repeat it for like let's say, so all is S. So let's say I'm going to repeat this formula there, it should show me nothing there. Let me copy it and paste it there, this one. So let me copy this formula. Okay, this one, and paste it there. It should show me none, nothing. Okay, so it is the D38. So the D38, let's say I'm going to press enter. So you can see that our formula is working. If it is going to be equal to this pay type is going to equal to W, it's going to show me the salary, else it is going to give me none. Okay, so we have completed this formula, this one is done. Now we are going to collect the data from this file, the data. So again we are going to first get the data from that file. So let's say we are going to edit this formula. If it is going to equal to W, so we are going to implement v lookup, this one v lookup. And so if the we are going to get the values according to this one, the job code. Okay, so the job code, then place comma. Okay, then he is asking me to insert table array. I'm going to fetch the table array from here, this one. Okay, so then he is asking me to input the index. So what will be the index? Index will be 1, 2, 3. So I'm going to get the index 3. Okay, so again that I'm going to go for the exact match, this one, and I'm going to place the bracket to end the formula. Okay, so this one is done. Okay, what is the problem with this one? Let's see. We are fetching it from H4, then index is 3. So I guess there is a problem is table array, so that's why it's making a problem. So let us go for like table array. Okay, this one. Okay, now what is the problem with it? We have ended the formula, we have placed everything, false, 0, this is E4. Okay boy, it is taking the choice from the wrong number. We have to collect from the job code, so it will be E4. You have to be very careful with the value that you want to select. Okay, now you can see that it is showing me the wage, because it is type pay type is weekly. So the pay type is W, it is showing me the annual wage. For that purpose I have to divide the data with 50, divide the data with 50. Then why the data we are going to divide it with 50? The reason is that in the start of the paper you have seen that he's saying that the employees are paid to work for the 50 weeks in a year. Okay, so whenever a employee is going to get paid weekly, it's mean that it is working 50 weeks in a year. So that was this salary that is given to us, it is annual salary. So there are 50 weeks in a year, so we are going to divide this salary by 50. Okay, then what? Then again if we go to this one, so then But if we go to the next point, in the next point he's asking that in cell G4 enter a formula to calculate the monthly salary for this employee if the pay type is S. If the pay type is not S, do not display anything. All we have to do, what it is very easy, he's saying that we have to implement this same condition, but we have to replicate that it should be S here. So I'm going to just copy this formula, this one, okay, then just I'm going to save it there, paste it there. I'm going to change the condition from W to S, okay. So it is going to go for the monthly salary, so there are 12 months, and we also have to change the 50 because it was according to the, that is annual salary, and there is only 12 months in a year, so annual salary will be divided by 12 in the case of monthly, okay. That was the weekly wage, so we are dividing it with the 50, and now you can see that it is the monthly wage, so we are going to divide it with the 12 according to the month formation. Then press enter. It is going to only show me in the case of where if the pay type is S, so that you can see that the pay type is not, that it is not going to show me anything there, okay. So what is next? We have completed this one. It is not displaying me anything. Replicate this formula from step 17 to 19 for the all employees, okay. So we have to replicate this formula, but before going to replicate this formula, we are going to do what, we are going to make few things before that. He is saying that the currency should be in Indian rupees and it should be two decimal places. For that purpose, we are going to do that, we are going to make both of these entries, we are going to change their type, it should be currency and it should be in number formation. I'm going to go for there in the currency, I'm going to go for Indian, so the Indian will be here, this one, it is Indian rupees, okay. So it is two decimal place as by requirement. If there is not, we have to change this one. I'm going to place okay there. Same goes to for this one. I'm going to again the data type, change the data type here, the currency, and it should be Indian rupees, Indian, okay, this one Indian rupees, two decimal place, press okay. Now I'm going to replicate this one. This one, so you can see that it is showing me where the salary is monthly. For the weekly, I'm going to again replicate from to the this one. This one is done. You can see that, and we have completed our step number 21. Again, what is step number 22? You can see that in step number 22, he is asking to save and print the spreadsheet following format. First, what we have to do, it is in landscape orientation and the content of the all cell fully visible, okay. He is saying that I have to do what, save and print the spreadsheet showing the formula, okay. Okay, for that purpose, first I have to show the formula, this one. For that, I'm going to go for view and I'm going to show the formula. Okay, in the formula tab, you can go for like this is a show formula. I have to do what? I have to select this option. Now you can see that it is showing me the formula, okay. So I'm going to go for here, then press this one. So all content should be visible as per examiner requirement. you can see that all content of all cell should be full visible. For that I have to do what? I have to select the whole column. Again, we have discussed before, I'm going to select this one, double click. So I'm going to go for the control P. So all content should be visible and it should be landscape. For the landscape purpose, I'm going to go for page setup and I'm going to make it landscape. Okay, this one. Okay, so now you can see that landscape page. Okay, so you can see the formulas are there. Okay, every content is visible. Okay, as per examiner requirement, he's not asking for I have to display this thing in a single page. Okay, so I'm going to go for like okay, this one is good. Okay, so I'm going to do what? As I'm not having a printer, so he's asking me to make evidence. So I'm going to do what? As per requirement, I have to make printout one and make sure that you have entered your name, candidate number, so the spreadsheet showing the formula. Okay, so for that purpose, I'm going to do what? I'm going to be like here. I'm going to make it print. Okay, so I'm going to write print out one with my name is Shamil, and then candidate number EK964, then 0099. This is my, you can say that whatever I just want to. I'm going to save this thing on my working area. So I was saving my file here, there, like this one. I was saving my file there. I'm going to save it. This is my printout number one. Again, what he's asking in the step number 23, he's asking print the spreadsheet showing the value, make sure it should fit on a single page, all the content of the cell fully visible. Okay, so now I don't want to show my formula, so I'm going to unshow it. Good. Again, I'm going to make it visible quite. Okay, this one is done. Okay, you can say that all the content is visible. So he don't ask for like any orientation, but he's asked me that all the data should be visible on a single page. So I'm going to do what? I'm going to make it print, control P. Okay, I'm going to change the orientation, page orientation. It should be like now land portrait. Okay, so still it is on two pages, so I'm going to make it fit on one. So I'm going to do what? Fit to one page, press OK. Now the whole data is fit on one page as per examiner requirement. Control P. Okay, this one I'm going to make it print. Now I'm going to save it as a print of two with my name and further details. Okay, it is saved. Make sure you have to follow these steps if you want to retrieve all the marks, okay, asked by the examiner. If you are going to lack your evidence, so examiner is going to give you lack of marks. Then in step number 24, extract only the employees who earn less than 200 rupees in a week. Okay, sort the exec into ascending order for the surname and print the spreadsheet on folio value, print out fit on a single page, all the content should be visible. So we have to using sort the extract. I have to implement sort on the surname ascending order, and I have to make a filter like here on the filter. I'm going to do what? Extract the employee who earn less than 200 rupees. So for that, first I'm going to make the filter. I'm going to do what? For the filter, I'm going to select them, this one, go to home, then sort and filter. There I am going to go for the filter. Okay, so he's asking the weekly wage should be, it's only going to display me those whose weekly wage is less than 200. So number filter should be greater than, less than equal to, he's asking me what, it should be less than, not equal to. So I'm going to select less than 200. Well, I'm going to go there, select this one, it should be less than 200. So I'm going to go for less than 200 rupees. So press OK. So now it is going to show me only those labors whose value is less than 400. Then I'm going to sort them from ascending order on the surname. This is a surname from A to Z, this one. Now sorting is done according to the surnames. Okay, so this is done, we have implement the filters there. Now he's asking me that what I have to make the print out of them. Okay, so I'm going to print out the spreadsheet for that. Control B again, then simply no further thing is required, it is fitting over single page. Okay, print them as the name of printout 3. Okay, printout 3, and the other things are completed, this one. Okay, so saved it. Then what, this one is done, he's saying that save and print your evidence file into printout 4. So I'm going to save my evidence file, print my, so evidence file there, this is my evidence file, I'm going to control P here. So I'm going to print this one. So again, if I want to save this thing on my particular folder, my working folder, that is there, this one, print out 4 as a name of printer 4, this one. So this is the thing asked by examiner. Make sure beta, you have to, students, but you have to do what, you have to complete your evidence file. If you are not going to compile them as well, examiner is not going to give you marks, because he is going to go for the evidence file. If evidence won't be there, then you won't get any marks. So student, this is how we are going to solve our Excel past paper. Everything is done. So I'm going to place the link of the resource files including the past paper in the description of this video. Thank you for watching. If you have any question, you can comment there.